Welcome to week 3 of November. This week's story is about Ruth and Naomi and Boaz, and it comes from Ruth chapters 1 and 2. So if you want to read that ahead of time, it'll kind of give you a little bit of the history of Ruth and Naomi and how they met Boaz and all the things that Boaz did for them and their family. It's a very good story. And so our theme this week is I'm thankful for people who help me because Boaz helped Ruth and Naomi. So everything that we do this week is going to be about helping people, and Boaz provided food for them, so some of the stuff we're going to be doing is going to be about food. So it should be pretty fun and good for all their imagination. So the first activity is called setting the table, and you have a picture, like a placemat, and it's got all the different things on it that you would need to have dinner. And then you can give the kids the plate and the cup and the spoon and have them set them on the placemat, and they can take turns, or you can talk about, you can show them the picture and have them tell you what goes where, and just to kind of help them learn about setting the table and setting a place for a friend. And then the second activity is called Welcome to My Restaurant, and this one should be pretty fun. So everybody's got some little makeshift waitress notepads, and so you can get some of the pens and stuff out of your drawer, crayons if you have those, and let the kids walk around and pretend they're waiters or waitresses and take each other order.
That is so cute.
And ask them what they want. And, you know, they can scribble it down and write it down and tear it off and give them their receipt. My kids love to play restaurant at home, and so they're always walking around taking everybody's order and stuff. So this could be pretty fun. And if you, there's not a lot of pieces of paper in here, but if everybody's really having a good time and you need more paper, just ask and somebody can go in the art room and get you some more construction paper or whatever so you can add on to that. Because that should be pretty cute. And we can talk about how waitresses and waiters and servers and all that, how they help people who are hungry, because that's what Boaz in our story did, was he helped someone who's hungry. And then the third activity is called help, and that's using the memory verse. And so you can see who remembers the memory verse, and they can do it by themselves. Or if you have someone in your class who's shy or someone who thinks they know but they don't want to do it by themselves, ask them if they want to pick someone to help them. Or if you want to just call on a couple of people and say, who wants to help me say the verse? So we're going to, this is kind of a double thing this week. We're going to be going over the verse and trying to reinforce the verse, but we're also really reinforcing helping each other and standing alongside each other and saying the verse. And then the transition activity, when you're walking from place to place, is called Help Needed. And have them pair up and talk about ways they can help each other, and have them, they can walk arm in arm in a line to wherever you're going, and talk about, you know, how they can help and that kind of stuff. And then the craft this week, it's pretty simple. It's some grain. I'm thankful for people who help me, and so they can.
We're thankful for bread. That's what that really is.
Exactly. So they can color the grain, and then we have some yellow bingo markers, and so they can just put a little yellow dot in the heart. So it shouldn't be too much of a mess today, because they're not putting bingo markers all over the whole thing, just doing the little yellow dots, and we should have plenty of these for everybody to share. So if you just, once again, keep your eye on bingo markers, so they, you splat them, they will go everywhere and make a mess. But they're supposed to be washable. But anyway, and now that you've watched the entire video and heard all our ramblings about all the things that we're going to be doing this week, here is the super special surprise for those of you that made it to the end of the video. If you come in on Sunday, the first person to come in and tell Ashley the secret word of the week, which is cauliflower. So the first person that comes in and says cauliflower to Ashley will get a super special surprise. And this one's a good one. So thank you for watching the video, and good luck to you on Sunday. I hope somebody wins the prize.
I can't wait to hear somebody come in and just say cauliflower.
You can come in and you can walk in the room and the potting chair will be like, cauliflower. Or you can just come in and be like, excuse me, I need to tell you something. I'm cauliflower. I'm not really sure why, but cauliflower. So however you would like to come in, we are really excited about this week. And
it's a good prize.
And it's a super good prize. So cauliflower, that's what you got to remember. See you Sunday.
Bye.